Hello all and welcome back to the POW Solutions YouTube channel. What's good? The year has gone by really fast. I believe the last video I made was in January, and then the year went February, March, blah, 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 August, and here we are. We're in August instantaneously. I don't know where the time has went. We're pretty much halfway through 2019, which to me is a little scary how fast the year went, but it's all good. I feel like I haven't made a video in a while, and I felt like chatting. So I decided that I was going to do an update video, but at the same time, shout out some of these Black-owned makeup companies, which is why I'm coming to you fresh-faced. So this video is about showing love. I'm in no way a makeup artist. I've said that in the past. No way a guru. I actually normally don't even wear makeup. So this is just about showcasing these products and at the same time chit-chatting with you all, letting you know what's been going on. So these products come from the Vitamin M box. I have done a review on that box. If you haven't seen it, go ahead and check it out. And so I ordered myself another box just as a treat for myself, and it had a lot of products in it that I wanted to try out, so I thought I would try it out on camera. And so part two of this video will be me opening the box and showing you everything that is in the box, not just the cosmetics. This is just the cosmetics portion. Okay, so the first product is from a company called Solux Cosmetics. They are known for their liquid and powdered glow kits, and it says enjoy your champagne taste glow dust, plus we added a sample of our new liquid eyeshadow in the shade So Wealthy. So I'm going to be linking all the Instagrams of these companies below, and I'm also going to try to include a clip of their Instagram somewhere in this frame. So the next product is from a company called Lip Love, and I'm going to read from their Instagram. It says it's not lip gloss, it's Lip Love. It moisturizes and softens lips, vegan and cruelty free. So this is a good product. The next one is from Mod Girl Cosmetics, which I've talked about here on my channel before. And I think actually these two will go good together, this lipstick and this lip gloss. And then the last is from a company called Shoe Cosmetics. This is called Shoe Polish. Shoe Polish. Anyway, I'm not going to try this on in front of the camera, but I am going to paint my nails with this and see what it looks like. So let's get started. So I tried the liquid shadow and the gold dust, and I really like it. I'm gonna go ahead and insert a clip of my eyelids because it's hard to see it from this angle. But while we're doing that, I wanted to talk about updates, which was the first topic that I wanted to discuss. Where have I been? And I did make a video in January of 2019. And when I made that video, I was about 8 months pregnant. I had gotten pregnant in 2018, and then in February of 2019, I gave birth to a little girl. And it was a miraculous, amazing, life-changing event. And that has pretty much taken up my time, consumed my time since February. She is gonna be 6 months this month. The time has gone super, super fast. And one day, maybe I'll sit down and talk about my pregnancy journey after 40. We'll see. So the other update topic has to do with my hair. I did do a video about my lock journey, or starting my lock journey again, called the natural hair tag, or it's my hair tag. And I did get one question where someone asked if I was still growing locks. Obviously the answer is no. I cut my hair, which I typically do when I give birth or when I'm pregnant. And so right now I have kind of a teeny weeny afro. So that's the update on that. And then the third update had to do with the film that I reviewed in January. Well, I actually reviewed the trailer for Us by Jordan Peele in January. And, you know, I've seen the movie. It's really, really great. I kind of feel like my theory, the theory I had and what actually happened in the movie were pretty much similar. I did say I believe that it's not an external being chasing this family. If it's a doppelganger, then it has to be something that's connected to the family. And sure enough, I believe the plot of the film was Lupita Nyong'o's character had trauma, and her trauma had a family, and that family was tracing her. So I feel like I was pretty consistent. I think I was pretty, like, I was aligned with the theme of the movie. I knew it wasn't something external. And I was just making the point to say that the concepts behind horror films are going to be changing. So we'll see how that goes on in the future. So I'm wearing the Mod Girl First Day of Summer shade right now. I just put a little bit on, and then I'm going to put this Lip Love on top of it. So I was going to say, I actually like commenting and doing videos about film and art and culture, because in a lot of ways I feel like they are more authentic than your more quote-unquote reality-based entertainment, like news shows and social media. Sometimes I feel like art is more honest. So I did do Jordan Peele Us. I also did a video about When They See Us, which was a wonderful film, series on Netflix by Ava DuVernay, if I'm pronouncing her name correctly. And so I did do a commentary on that. And also in the past have done a commentary on Black Panther. And I just like to take these artistic expressions and kind of give them a broader perspective, you know.
Okay, so I had to move locations because it's like 5 p.m. and the lighting is really wonky. So I wanted to encourage you guys to check out some of these smaller cosmetic brands. I did list their Instagrams below. I did hear about that controversy with Juvia's Place, and I talk about that all the time. I talk about Black-owned businesses that do not support the concept of Ujamaa, which is just Black independent economics and just creating a Black-owned business for the purpose of making the culture better and advancing us collectively. So I just feel like a lot of people are confused. They're like, well, Juvia Place is a Black-owned business. Shea Moisture is a Black-owned business. Like, I can support them. Yeah, you can, but I also feel like some of these smaller brands, you know, check the messages behind them. They are actually, you know, in it for the collective and not just for themselves. And so that's why I appreciate Vitamin M Box for always promoting Black group economics. And so, like I said, part two of this video is me opening up the box that I received and checking out all the other goodies that's inside, not just the cosmetics.
So I'm glad we had a chance to chat. I'm glad I had a chance to update you and show you some of these awesome products. The link for Vitamin M Box will be below. And as always, stay tuned, stay woke, and stay powerful. I just really wanted to show you everything in this box, not just the cosmetics, and I also just wanted to showcase this company again, because once again, their values align a lot with my values. So once again, thank you for joining me, and as always, stay tuned, stay woke, and stay powerful.